new performance, a great goal.
Aye, good goal. Don't get them often, eh? So it's happy, just a shame there's no fans here. So I feel actually sorry on Dunfermline and our Go fans and everyone else in Scotland. It's just a shame what's happening just now, but hopefully we'll be back in the next few weeks.
In terms of the goal, did you know it was going in as soon as you hit it?
Aye, I did actually. I just caught it well. Like, I knew, I had a picture in my head, ran up to get the layoff for Anton, and I looked like it was clear as day, I was just going to hit it, and I kept my body over it, and it just rose into the sort of side netting. Good strike.
Is that your 12th team? Is that it?
Aye, 12 in the league, so it's been a great return for me. Just hopefully keep up. I'm obviously not known for goals, so it just shows you what a bit of confidence can do, and I'm playing in a part of a good team, and I'm playing in a good position on the field, which is sort of suiting my game, so hopefully I'll get a few more.
You could have played for the forward earlier in your career, but you're getting more goals from
the back. Yeah, I'm not an out and out striker, so I'm quite versatile. I can obviously do a sort of shift in a few positions, but I was playing off big Joel at the start of the season, and I got a bit of joy there, but now Anton's getting joy from him. Just shows you how good big Nubal is, and occupies two and three defenders at once, and then you find yourself free, like what Anton done. I got a few of them for Noobs at the start of the season, so now I'm playing deeper. It's just a different role, but not if the goals dry up. It's fine as long as we keep winning. We're sitting nice just now.
Have you set any? I mean, you say you're not known for goals for 12s or some return already. Have you set a target?
I've genuinely not, but obviously if I have another half like I did the first half of the season, I'd be absolutely delighted. Even if I got another few goals, I'd be happy. But as I say, like, it's what we're doing as a team that's the most important thing. If they can just keep up this form, the whole place has got a sort of feel-good factor about it. Don't want that to end.
If you can feel good when you're top of the league,
then. Aye, you're right. Aye, even off the field and the way everything's going, as I said, it's just a shame what's happened with the fans getting locked out just now. But I think they'll be back soon, hopefully mid-January, and they can help us on towards the end of the season.
Yeah, it's just 3 points clear at the top now. It seems to get better and better for you guys.
Inverness, their game is off there against Partick, and that's a tough game for them, so that's one of the top five teams going to be dropping points, or both of them if they draw. So it's going to get tasty, I think. You can obviously see a divide in the league, so it's getting... I think obviously some of the bigger teams will strengthen in January, so it's going to get tougher. We've not done anything yet.
So just keep doing as you're doing, that's the message.
It has worked, having that attitude. Just take each game. Like, even today we're turning up to play Dunfermline. Dunfermline are having a tough season for how big a club they are. But we're not turning up here thinking this is an easy game. We're still, in our head, underdogs here. They're a big club, really good individuals, and it's just, for whatever reason, it's not clicking just now for them, but I think they're capable of going on a run and even pushing for the playoffs.
Is it something new for you guys, though, to kind of try and deal with being where you are in the league?
Aye.
Because obviously you've had some good times in the last wee while, but
aye,
they're different. Are both in a different position in the league.
Yeah, especially in the Championship. Obviously League One was different because when we won League One, we were top since day one, and they stayed top the whole season. Championship is different, it's a different level of opposition, so it's going to chop and change. We're under no illusion how tough it's going to be like, but again, we're almost mathematically safe, which is going to take a lot of pressure off us going into games, and we tend to finish the season quite strong, so we're in a good position just now.
Personal note, you've agreed a new contract as well, you must be happy with that side of
things. Aye, happy. So obviously been a lot of success since I've came to Arbroath, and it's a great club, and we've got a good rapport with the fans, and everyone's together, and that's what I like about it. It's everything you do, we're all working class, and you sort of help each other out, and the fans are brilliant, the board, the manager, the staff, we're all in it together. But we need to keep that up, because things can change quickly in football, and we don't want that to end just now.
There's seven guys all so agreed new deals at the same time, so that kind of shows the
feel good
factor that
there
is at the club.
Yeah, everyone, we're all sort of good mates as well. A lot of us sort of talk and speak out of football, and it's just a sort of really good dressing room to be part of. Probably the best I've been involved with.
Cheers, Michael.